All right, so now we're gonna study about how this drug is gonna be moved to different phases of the kidneys to be finally excreted out in the form of urine, right? So this movement of drug from kidney to finally enter into the collecting duct to move and form the urine consists of three phases. First, the glomerular filtration phase, mark number one. Second is the proximal tubule, which is the secretory phase. So it is an active process, so your active tubular secretion. Third is the passive tubular reabsorption. And then finally, urine and all of the drug will be then moved out. So let's study one by one each of the steps. First is this one, that is the first step here, glomerular filtration. So if I say I take a drug, for example, I take folic acid. So that folic acid will then move from, for example, here you will have the renal artery. From that renal artery, the drug will move and enter into my glomerular capillary network. From these glomerular capillary network in the glomerulus, it will move into the Bowman's capsule. And this fluid that moves from my glomerulus into my Bowman's capsule is going to constitute the glomerular filtrate. And the normal value of this glomerular filtration rate is 125 milliliter per minute. And the nature of that drug, it will not affect this glomerular filtration process, but it will be the GFR rate or the disease of the kidney that will affect this process. Second is the active process, that is the tubular secretion. Now, if the drugs, they do not enter from the glomerulus into this Bowman's capsule, they're going to leave this glomerulus by means of efferent artery and enter into my nephronic lumen of the proximal convoluted tubule where secretion will take place. Then from here, we will consist of secretion of two energy-dependent active transport systems. If that drug is anion, it has a negative charge, then it will be your deprotonated form of weak acid secreted here. And if that charge has a positive ion on it, that drug, it will be your protonated form of weak base. And from here, it can go and transfer it to many different compounds and secrete many different compounds and other compounds, right? So all the secretion takes place here. Then from here is going to pass into the loop of Henle. From the loop of Henle, it enters into the distal tubule. When it enters into that distal convoluted tubule, it is going to mark the start of the third step of the kidney elimination. That is the passive tubular reabsorption. Now, as I said that the drug will pass from here to enter into the loop of Henle, from loop of Henle into the distal tube. For example, if I say that the concentration of that drug in the distal tubule is about 1 milligram, and on the outside it is 2 milligram, right? I'm sorry. Sorry, on the inside it is 2 milligram, and on the outside if it's one. So it is going to move from an area of higher concentration to an area of lower con. So the drug will then move out from the inner part of this distal convoluted tubule to enter outside in the blood where its concentration is low. That is if that thing, that drug here, will have no charge. Now, if that drug has a charge on it, then we must calculate and check the pH of the urine. Because if that drug, for example, is harmful, is toxic, we do not want that drug to enter into the blood. We want it to move out and out. We will check the pH. If that drug, for example, is basic, then we want to make sure that the urine is acidic so that they will combine with one another, cut each other's effect and result, neutralize it and move it out from the body in the form of urine. Or if that drug is basic, we will make sure that the acid is acidic urine so that they will neutralize it and then it will move out and will prevent it to go and diffuse into the bloodstream. This method is called as ion trapping, that is required when we have some sort of the drug that we want to remove. If we do not want to remove it and we want it to stay in our blood for a long time, then we will allow diffusion to take place and the drug will move from the distal convoluted tubule outside into the bloodstream and as well perform its function. That was how, by means of kidney, it is done, that from glomerular filtration, if not in the Bowman's capsule, from the bone into proximal conduit tubule secretion, and then from there finally enter into distal conduit tubule. From there, if we want to do it, there will be reabsorption of it into the blood. If we do not, we will stop this and will make sure that the urine is opposite to that of the nature of the drug. And as a result, then it will counterbalance it, and as a result, it will move out in the form of urine and be excreted out. That was through the kidney. Right, now we have through another method, that is by your lungs, by your blood, breast milk, by your saliva, by your sweat, which will be explained in the next video.